Violent clash as Lagos clamps down on daring Okada riders. Hello, my amazing family. You are going to come in contact with an awful lot of people who are at their absolute breaking point this season. While it may be the merriest time of the year for some, it is the saddest, loneliest, most stressful, heartbreaking for so many others. We are all busy. But not too busy to be kind, caring, and patient. Remember, the best thing you can give someone right now is love. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is a first thing. Thank you. I tell you, the only way to stop Okada in Lagos is to criminalize patronizing Okada. Any other thing will fail. Those boys from the north have taken over Lagos. I pity the government of Lagos because soon they will not be able to curtail those monsters from the north. Whereas, the sad point here is that the state in the north banned Okada only to deliberately ship them in trailers, everybody to the south. It was and still a well-mapped out plan sending to the south due to their evil plans. Imagine them threatening how they have the numerical strength to fight the police. Yes, force numerical strength is what they told them to use in the south. It is left to the state government if to allow them destroy a state for party affiliation or save it, just as the north have done and are still doing. Lagos, as we know, is a metropolis. Okada is not needed. They are keg of gunpowder. They must go. The news in details. More than ever before, commercial motorcycle operators, popularly known as Okada riders in Lagos State, now constitute a menace to the residents and the government. Recently, they have become so daring and emboldened to act in manners detrimental to safe living in the society. They operate with unregistered motorcycles and seem to be running a parallel government as they flagrantly disobey orders, restricting them from plying certain routes. Besides assaulting other innocent road users at slightest provocation and attacking police personnel on duty, have become the order of the day. Chijoke writes on the need to check the incessant violence and vandalism of police stations and burning of police vehicles by Okada riders. Okada riders would have killed me on Sunday morning if not for my friends from 23rd Road who came at the right time and guarded me out of their hands while they were beating me. With these words, Mr. Jimmy Sulekon Etelo and father of four recanted the maltreatment he suffered in the hands of Okada riders in Lagos. Sulekan, popularly known as Awilo, was last Sunday beaten beyond recognition by Okada riders while videoing a week-long clash that erupted between the police and the riders in Festac. Some police personnel had stormed 7th Avenue, impounded some commercial motorcycles, and took them away. The riders regrouped themselves, waylaid the police officers and burnt three of their patrol vehicles that they used for the operation. Awilo said it was in a shop at 7th Avenue, K Close, Festac, when his wife went out to church, came back and told him that there was a fight going between the police and Okada riders on the street, and he woke up from his bed to see things for himself. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is a first time. Thank you. On getting outside to wash his face, he saw four Okada riders running into the close. He challenged them to go out as Okadas and not allowed into the close, but they threatened to stab him to death with a Awusa-made dagger. Luckily for Awilo, some other residents of the close who had been alerted by the altercations that ensued between him and the commercial motorcyclists joined forces with him to push them away and lock the gate to the close. Awilu later went out to record what was happening with the aim of posting it to Close's WhatsApp platform to inform others on the development. While doing that, the Okada men swooped on him with slapping and beating using a flat surfaced plank and prevented him from videoing their clash with the police. Awilu recanted, it was while they were beating him that 23 road boys. By then, neighbors at 23rd Road saw me and gathered me out of their hands. One of the elderly people told them to check what I was videoing, so they checked my phone and deleted the videos. These people are bad. They do not have respect for the police. Look at how they vandalized the 7th Avenue police post. All the vehicles parked there were destroyed. They burnt 3 police vans. There are other accounts of the reason for the fight between the police and the Okada men. An eyewitness, Mr. Mustafa Abiola, told The Guardian that the police from Aluasa came to the 7th Avenue and impounded some Okadas and took them away in continuation of their raid that the Aluasa Task Force started last Friday. A long second rainbow in my two axes. Another account by Kole Ajani has it that the Sunday's raiding was a response to complaints made by some landlords and residents whose front edges are being used as a party ground every Sunday. They said they were being denied free access to their homes. Please don't forget to give us a like or a thumbs up if this is your first time. Thank you. In response to the petitions, the task force visited the area and took away some vehicles. But the daring Okada riders revolted. Some of them, with shams, removed their clothes and started walking towards the police, who responded by using tear gas canisters to disperse them. As the confrontation was going on, other riders at the 7-Eleven end of the road had blocked the exit road with logs and used tires such that the policemen, who fled on foot, could not move their vehicles. It was then that they poured fuel on the police vehicles and set them ablaze. One could see the thick balloon of dark smoke from a distance as the 3 vehicles were on fire, he said. It was once said that Lagos was sitting on a keg of gunpowder, owing to the influx of undocumented northerners and immigrants from neighboring countries, especially those with questionable characters. The Guardian newspaper investigation reveals that these foreigners, who could hardly speak English, initially stopped in the north, specifically Kano, to learn Hausa language before moving down south to take up the job of riding Okadas. The restriction of Okada riders in some areas may not work because their operation in those areas is still very pronounced. Despite the governor's hard works, Okada riders are still operating on Oshodi Maitu Expressway, Oshodi Ikeja, along Maitu, Orile, Lagos Badagry, Ikeja, Ojota, and Maryland. My people, they are everywhere. Each time I want to cross the road, I pray hard because of these demons called Okada riders. And let's be frank to ourselves. The so-called Okada riders are Fulanis brought into the country by the Fulani criminalized assassin presidency. The agenda is straightforward. Jihad. Any further delay to tackle these challenges will cost the nation and turn it to Afghanistan. That is my submission. And I tell you, getting Okada riders off Lagos Road, it's as difficult as getting the devil out of town. Any government that will achieve this feat must do both physical and spiritual preparations first. Those ones within the streets are still tolerable, but the ones on the express is not only an eyesore, but also blood-sucking demons. Please, if you're here for the first time, there's a bell on the right and on the left, and please click on it for more updates. And most importantly, tell a friend to tell a friend about Turn the ways media. God bless you. Bye-bye.